In this segment, we'll look at an example of how to find rank of a set of vectors. So let's suppose somebody says, hey, given these three vectors, a1 is equal to 25, 64, 144, a2 is equal to 5, 8, and 12, and a3 is given as 1, 1, 1, find the rank of this set of vectors. So you're given these three vectors right here, and somebody's asking you for the rank of this set of vectors. In the previous example, we found out that a1, a2, a3 are linearly independent. So since we found out that, hey, a1, a2, a3 are linearly independent, so the rank of set of vectors in this case will be equal to 3, because we found that three vectors are linearly independent. Now keep in mind that you don't only simply count the number of vectors which are linearly independent, but you also have to look at the dimension of the vectors. The dimension of the vectors is 3, and as we said, that the rank of the set of vectors has to always be less than or equal to the dimension of the vector, which in this case is 3, so we are all right here. If somebody gave you something like this, and somebody said, hey, A1 is given as 25, 64, 144, A2 is given as 5, 8, 12, so I'm using the same three vectors which are given to me in the example, and somebody says, hey, I'm giving you the fourth vector, A4 equal to 2, 7, and 19. Now, in this case, whether this set of vectors is linearly independent or not, all four of them, will not matter to decide whether the rank of the set of the vectors is 4. Because the dimension of the vectors is only 3. So the only thing which we have to show is we want to get the rank of a set of vectors is going to be less than or equal to 3, because the dimension of the vectors is 3. So all we have to show is whether 3 of these vectors are linearly independent. So we already found out that if I use a1, a2, and a3, they are linearly independent. So that gives me that, hey, I got three vectors which are linearly independent. So the maximum number of the vectors which are independent here are linearly independent is at least 3. So the rank of vectors is equal to 3. So it doesn't matter whether all four of them are independent or not. So A4 can be linearly dependent, let's suppose, on these other three vectors, or it can form a linearly independent set of vectors, all four of them. But it wouldn't matter that, hey, it will, if you have to decide what the rank of the vectors is going to be less than or equal to 3. So it is always going to be less than or equal to 3, but the reason why we say it's exactly 3 is because we at least found three vectors, A1, A2, and A3, which are linearly independent. And that's the end of this segment.